It's about how do you actually spend within your means, if you were to ask me.
I've heard people pay, like, max out a credit card, take out a personal loan, and also refinance their home or something for their wedding. Not the marriage, just the wedding. Is that what they call the debt trap? Because there's this term that people just throw around like nothing. Oh, you're in a debt trap right now. What yep. is the debt trap?
Basically, debt traps is like what you've just explained. You know, you do things without realizing what's the consequences and how taking a loan, for example, or maxing your credit cards or overspending from the budgets that you are, I mean, the boundaries of the budgets that you actually have set for yourself, and how this could easily be a snowball effect to bigger debts. So basically, that's the debt trap. Anything in terms of the financial arena could possibly be a debt trap that you're walking into. I've even heard before, JD, you know, in the 90s, there's a lot of people who buy property in bulk.
Yeah.
You know, people exactly. who buy, you know, 5-10 properties kind of thing, you know, and yeah. then they're only earning like, you know, 4-5-figure income. And
I always wonder how they did that.
So can you just imagine at this point in time now where no one's renting from you, you've got 10 properties, great, and maintenance fees to pay? Can you yeah. just imagine what kind of debt are you in?
Have you ever had to deal with someone?
Mm-hmm.
Because you're trying to plan their financials, right? And then you want to long-term this, that, whatever. And then you look mm-hmm. at their numbers, they're like, you have how many credit cards and they're all maxed out? How do you help someone like that?
I think it comes back to bare basics then. If the fundamentals of, you know, their spending habits, their mindset about money, you know, how do they actually, you know, correct those aspects first before we actually move on to bigger things that they want to achieve? Because think about it, the situation that they're in, very likely, if you've maxed out on everything, your cash flow is not going to be good. It's definitely a negative cash flow situation on a monthly basis. And that's the first step you need to do in order to correct it before you get any further. But I think it's actually all about being disciplined. It's all about, you know, having good habits in terms of the way you spend. You know, I'm not saying that, you know, I'm a miser and I don't spend on anything and, you know, being stingy and all. But you just have to plan that spending, you know,
yeah.
like, for example, like now, if you're getting a pay cut at this point in time, you can't be going to Starbucks every day and having your coffee. Nothing's wrong with, you know, making your own coffee at home or going to a kopitiam to have your decent coffee. It's still
yeah.
coffee.
Yeah.
You know, it's about how do you actually spend within your means, if you were to ask me. Like a lot of us, you know, I'm really surprised with some of the clients that I actually have. They've got 3-4 cars or 3-4 vehicles. How many person are you? You're only one person. How many cars do you really need?
Yeah.
Why do you need so many? Because times are good. You've got the money to splurge on certain things. You do it. But at this point in time, you ask yourself, is it really logical for us to take those actions?
Yeah.
Sometimes the answer is no.
Yeah.
You know, so I think it's actually, again, back to basic habits, you know, the good habits, you need to be in control of your finances. You need to be very clear what purchases are really necessity and what purchases are just nice to have.
Everyone out there, if you could just give 3 pieces of advice or even one really good
right.
one
mm-hmm.
about debt, about their debt.
I would say start looking at all the debts that you have, put them all into one page and be very clear in terms of what debts you have right now. Okay, and the most important thing that you need to figure out also is how to consistently be able to clear them over a period of time. Look into your finances, you know, have
right.
a very clear picture in mind. That would be a start, I would say.
Hey guys, we hope you loved that discussion. But for the full discussion and all our other videos, click right here. And remember, don't be a dick.